So, why don't you guys join me? Well, let's start. So, good morning, and thank you for being here with us today. We take with great pride the fact that we are the innovation partner of the world's most creative minds. We are in a journey of reinvention. Behind reinvention, there's the need for innovation, and the company believes, it's a fundamental belief, that anyone, everywhere, is capable of reinventing life for the better. As you've seen over the last 2 days, we have a long history with the movie industry, starting with our founders and Disney Fantasia to all the work that you just saw in the previous panels. We create tools for reinvention of the movie industry. But in spite of all the technology, everything is about storytelling. And behind storytelling, there's people. People, emotion, and the need for connection. So we're here to talk about diversity. We take diversity very serious at HP. For us, it's not just a values issue, it's a business imperative. Why? Because more than 50% of our consumers are women, and because we participate in a global environment. So we want to talk about diversity within the film industry, and I'm just going to give you three numbers that, frankly, as being the father of five daughters, struck me. 7, 24, 13. 7% of all directors of the top 250 films around the world are women. Just 7. 24, producers. 13, writers. Only a third of all the speaking parts of all the top 250 movies around the world were given to women. That, frankly, is embarrassing because it doesn't represent the community that actually goes to see the movies. So we're here to talk about that. So for that, we have an amazing panel, some of the world's most creative minds. So we have Nandita Das from India. She's a filmmaker and actress and also a social activist. We've had the pleasure of working with her, and she's just releasing her new movie, Manto. We also have Anand Singh, which is the most renowned filmmaker in South Africa, over 80 films. And he is an expert, actually, in the business of movies, and I'm going to be talking to him about what drives the industry. And then we have Crystal Mosel, who's also a documentarian and a commercial producer from the Free the Bid work that HP has been very proud to sponsor. So let me start with Nandita. I see the numbers, like you see the numbers. Why is it so hard?
I asked that question myself. How did we even get here? We hold up half the sky, and I have no idea why such inequality exists. I guess like most industries, I mean, film industry has been a very male-dominated industry. It has, women have continued to juggle in their lives. So therefore, if a woman gets pregnant, if a woman marries, you know, when you become an actor, if you marry, the first question in India, they say, would you continue acting? And you know, that a question that is never asked to men. If you have a child, they ask you the same thing. So would you still work? And you say, yes, of course. So I think that kind of an inequality has existed for far too long. And 7%, probably in India, the figures would be even lower than that. Because that perception that women will not be able to handle the pressures of films, the perception, especially in a country where there's a lot of mainstream cinema, that women will just not get it, how to make it big, how to make it sort of, there's more action, and you know, these genres like action and horror and all of that is not something that women will be able to handle. So women are fine in front of the camera as long as they look beautiful, they cry, they dance, all that's good. But behind the camera, they're mostly assistants. You seldom find women in leadership roles. And having acted in about 40 films and directed two, I think the more sophisticated we get, the more polished we get, the subtler the inequalities become. And when they become subtle, they are also more difficult to negotiate with. I mean, you know, so nobody is going to come and give me a sexist comment or say something that's outright offensive. If that were to happen, that would probably be easier because then you can sort of counter it more easily. But when it's subtle, it's like an actor and a female actor and a male actor giving suggestions to a director. The way a female actor's suggestion is dismissed, or when you're directing, you ask for something and they say, oh, come on, stop whining or stop crying. The usage of words. So I think that is a bigger challenge. Women in general go through a lot of sense of guilt that sometimes men find it difficult. I don't know if women here feel that way because they're constantly juggling and therefore they come with a lot of guilt. So the responsibility of creating that equality, I think, lies on men and women both, because we are also conditioned to take the lower end of the stick. So it's not easy to just say, okay, women should go out there and do it. It's a conditioning, it's a generational conditioning of stepping back, of not being so aggressive, not being pushy, you know, being nurturing, wanting to handle everything. So it's going to take time, but I think the time has come where it has suddenly become a buzzword and there's a lot of tokenism. But with that, I think we are making inroads. Sometimes these buzzwords and tokenism and people writing in the media, all that's a good thing, because through that you're forced to address issues that one hasn't for so long.
Great. At the end of the day, this is a business. And business get moved by financial well-being, first and foremost. In the commercial industry, several years ago, the realization that 85% of all purchases comes from free mail was one of the key drivers for many of the companies to begin to move. And then you have a systematic, holistic approach. So you have a business case, then the clients, who are actually driving the industry, make it a priority. When the clients make it a priority, they begin to tell the agencies, I want diverse teams in my group. When the agencies begin to move, then you also need the directors. And the client can actually make the decision of who that director eventually is going to be. And then ultimately, you're going to be able to measure all these results. So when you take a look at the commercial industry, the throat to choke, the person to impact is the client. If the client moves, everything moves. Who's the client that needs to move in the film industry?
Well, that's a very good question, Antonio. I think, you know, when you put the film together, there are so many interesting components. And the case in point with two of my recent films, one which is called Below Her Mouth, which is a total women's film. There's no men on any of the credits, from the person, the technical, the creative, director, producers, and I helped put it together. I elected not to take a credit because I wanted to make that statement that it is an important component of going forward to make sure and support the gender component of women filmmakers in every aspect of film. So, interestingly enough, there was a lot of skepticism, and you know, and this comes up all over the place. And you've heard from Nandita, and I'm sure Crystal will say the same thing, that you know, ultimately the audience will decide, and no one knows what the audience is going to say or do. So, in this case in point, we made the film. It's a tiny budgeted film. I just helped put the financing together, and you know, the film has now been released. It's gone on to Netflix. It's got amazing reviews, the New York Times, the Washington Post, and now it's finding its audience and reaction. So, you know, you never know, and audiences will find your movie, you know, because it is that something that appeals to them. But another case in point from South Africa, and as an African, I think when we talk about diversity, and I started my filmmaking career in the apartheid era, and race is a very important component also, because whether it's Latin, African, you know, that is making inroads, but it's still far too late, and you've demonstrated the statistics on women. So I made a little film in South Africa, which everybody said, you can't do this, and you know, nobody's going to go see it. It's a woman's story set in a world of HIV and AIDS and the stigma. And you know, it was in indigenous language, Zulu, in South Africa. And we made the film despite all the negativity, and it ultimately turned out to be the first South African film to be nominated for an Academy Award. HBO picked it up for the whole world. And so, you know, you have to keep pushing the envelope. And I think, as Nandita said, in countries like India, African countries, and many others, the male domination has been a very significant thing, and it's even more significant when you succeed to actually get a film made. And we have to push that envelope and try to change those statistics.
Great. Crystal, you represent Free the Bid. Free the Bid is an amazing project. As I was in HP working through the whole diversity initiative through Twitter, this young lady called Alma Hartel tweets me and says, we're representing Free the Bid. Free the Bid aims at ensuring that clients like ourselves, before they assign a commercial product, that they make sure that at least one of the three bids that are required for compliance is a woman. And I said, oh, that's a great idea, fits with our diversity. So I signed, she was very, very grateful, and she sends me a note back. And she said, Antonio, it would be very helpful for us if you were to name your 10 favorite female directors. And I was very honest, so I sent her a note back and said, Alma, I am afraid to say that I don't know female directors in our commercial, at least during the last 3-4 years. And she said, don't feel bad, because I myself had a hard time thinking of 10. She said, I'm trying to fix that. I am going to create a site whose number one objective is to drive awareness of all the female creative directors that are all over the world, so that clients like you can actually look at that reel and then tell the agencies, hey, you guys can look at that. So at that moment, I contacted her and said, we're going to help you fund the site. And today is over 390 directors, right?
Yeah, well, it's great, because through the site you can, you know, because there's all these ideas like, oh, women can't do comedy, women can't do car commercials. And through the site you can search and find all sorts of women that do all these sorts of types of directing. And it's amazing, because when Alma's a good friend of mine, and when she told me about this initiative, like when it launched, that week, like I got more calls than I'd ever gotten in my life. And it's continued. And I think it's working, and it's actually like putting things into action. And I'm just like, I feel honored to be here to represent Alma, because she like has such a force with this initiative, and to have you guys support it as well. It's a beautiful thing, and it's working.
Great. So in the case of commercial production, we found out that one of the big hurdles, one was the clients, which we spoke about. The other one was awareness of the female directors. Mm-hmm. What is the hurdle in the film industry? Is it awareness of the female directors, or are there other hurdles that we haven't spoken about, Nandita or Anant?
I mean, I did this program with Universal, where we went in and spoke with them about, like, you know, they wanted to bring women in to like talk about, you know, directing features. And there was like such a big initiative to like change things in the industry, and the numbers have only gone down. So it's almost like Free the Bid needs to expand to Hollywood, to the studios, because I think that they also need to like actually take action. So
to the film at the official screening, and I think they have on the logo of the Cannes Film Festival the steps as the screen, you know, and I was looking at the credits of the directors that they had on that, and I think there's probably one or two females. Wow. So that tells you 70 years, you know, so that was troublesome, but it's good that we are here talking about this, because we need to push it and change it. And
but what are the hurdles? What
with HP's influence with the festival, I think you need to start pushing it there.
Oh, we will. What do you think, Andita?
What are the hurdles?
What do you think are the hurdles?
In being female director?
No, in not. So in the case of commercials, was the fact that there was no awareness of the fact that there are at least 390 that we could draw from to actually film those commercials. What is the hurdle in the film industry? Is it awareness of the female directors, or it's stronger than that? Is a rejection?
No, I think it's much more subtle than that. It's because finally, if you're good at your work, people will take you. You know, your caste, like in India we have caste, but caste, religion, race, gender. But to be good, there's been such a lot of historical wrong that firstly, there is no level playing field. So already there are very few women in the pool. And from that, there isn't that awareness because everybody wants to play safe. You know the five names. If you're doing a big commercial, you have your usual suspects.
Yes.
You take from that. You have those five token African actors, your five token or two probably Indian actors. You don't look beyond. So to look beyond, to genuinely follow an idea that you believe in, it requires some amount of hard work. So it's not going to just happen. So it's great that you have a side. Please come to India as well. We have a lot of Indian female directors. We'd like to put ourselves out there.
That would be great, actually.
So I think it's also about following your action with your intention. And then, you know, then you'll just have to look harder. And so, for instance, a website like yours, I didn't know about it. Because there's so much out there. So how do we also create that kind of awareness and put all these things in the public domain? Otherwise, we are all living in our insular worlds and sort of happy with whatever little we are doing. But how do we sort of connect? And I think these kind of platforms are great. I mean, a place like Cannes brings in such a mix from very successful Hollywood people to totally independent. But again, if you see, they all live in their own little world. So I think we just need to know, we just need to open ourselves to more experiences and more interactions so that we can know about such wonderful initiatives.
Yeah, because also, I mean, I think that the idea is for Free the Bid, the website, to become like the IMDb of female directors. Because it's not like, I have a production company that I work with, they're called Some Such, and they're wonderful, and they're very supportive of women. But through this website, I just did a job for eBay, and they found me through Free the Bid because Alma suggested me to that agency. So it's becoming, in the advertising world, it's actually becoming a staple, and it's a way for people to get inspired and like search out women. And absolutely, like, you should connect with us and give us suggestions of women in India that direct commercials,
yeah,
or
because
films.
India seems so far away. When something starts in America, it does take a long time for it to come to India.
We'll make
we'll
a bridge.
It's great. We are making the bridge right now.
Perfect. Yeah.
Well, you know, I've worked with about 15 of my movies were directed by women, and you know, it's been very interesting that the projects came along, and you have the same process that you would have with a man, you know, and the passion and the storytelling. And we just made those movies. And I remember one, you know, she had a few people, technical people, that she wanted to work with on the film. And there was a sync that they had together that, you know, I haven't seen on many other sets. That, you know, obviously they worked together before.
Well, one of the things that I've learned through the process is that the moment those three categories that we spoke about, director, writer, and producer, the moment that a woman or person of color hits one of those three jobs, the entire dynamic in the set changes. The number of women grows, the number of people of color grows, and the overall process becomes rather a more creative endeavor. Is that the case? I mean, you're just in the middle of the process, Nandita.
Yes, absolutely. I think it makes a big difference. I have two heads of departments who are women. And I think what is good is that very organically happens. You're not trying to make... Of course, in a lot of places, you have to make that conscious effort. But when it is a subconscious, when it is organically, you anchor towards people who You know, I mean, the film that I'm making, Manto, he always wrote about people on the margins of society. And it came to him also very naturally. So I think it's not something one is trying to push, which one should in any case, but I think very organically my team is very diverse. Like a woman composer, music composer, we hardly have any women composers. And why is that the case? I mean, it's not like women can't sing or don't have a musical ear. Sometimes you just wonder, we are not weightlifting in music composing or in editing or these kind of, like my production designer is a woman. And so yes, it is fairly diverse.
Do you find that to be the case, Anand, as well?
You know, it really, that's a very good point that the way the industry works, and I mean, Hollywood is, you know, if we take these statistics, they're actually quite good, but Hollywood is terrible. Yeah. You know, I think there's a few, there may be three woman directors that you could put on that A list of movie directors of 50 that they would immediately sign up onto. You know, it's really sad, but, you know, I think that one of the things that I can sort of share is that growing up in South Africa with a white, this industry was totally white. So I came in here trying to make a movie and I kind of feel the same way as the gender balance that everything, you know, they would give a white person credit, they didn't give me credit. You know, it's purely, you know, and it was law. So, you know, and I can feel that women have to actually go through those similar type of hurdles, but ultimately, if you want to be successful and passionate, you will succeed.
What do you think, Crystal?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's just, it's about the awareness and taking the steps, like when, like I'm shooting a film in a couple weeks, and I really like all my producers are women. I have, it's a very diverse crew. I think it's just making that step to think about it and then take action.
The one thing that I found as we were going through our own journey, it took us about a year and a half to balance my top senior marketing positions. We started with, I have 10 direct reports. We started with two females. 18 months later, we have 5 and 5. But it wasn't because we wanted to fill chairs with females. And I get actually a bit insulted. Everyone tells me, so, well, we should talk about capability as opposed to diversity. Mm-hmm. For me, it's, and I want your point of view on that because I take it very personal, it's capability is a given. I will never put my business or movie or a in jeopardy just because we want better representations. Somehow that message is not getting through. The fact that I have a balanced department means that I have the best department that I can gather, and happens to be that the 5 women that work with me are kick-ass women, and I feel very proud of them. Is it the same in the film industry?
Well, you know, you don't want to compromise, but you know, it's the same criteria. I mean, as an independent film producer, I would evaluate a film irrespective of gender. You know, and I think that's the only way I know to do it, because if the project comes along, you know, you talk it through and you either do it or you don't. You know, you don't see gender or color, or at least I don't.
Yeah, I mean, when people ask me, how does it feel to be a woman director? I'm like, I don't know how it feels to be a male director. But, you know, I mean, you're a director, but you happen to be a woman. And I'm sure my being a woman probably influences certain things. But just as my being brown, my being from India, my, you know, my upbringing, everything influences. I mean, we all have multiple identities. I don't have to wear it on my sleeves. And I'm a big champion of multiple identities, and you know, no one identity ought to be thrusted on us. But having said that, I do find myself sort of feeling much more a woman than all the other identities. I think it's because the world just never lets you forget that identity, whether in a flattering way or in a putting down way or in a marginalizing way. That's an identity that always keeps playing up. So when I'm now doing a film about a man, and, you know, I was telling you, Antonio, the other day that, you know, often people ask me that, oh, you're such a feminist, you've done so much work on gender issues. Why are you doing a film about a man? So, I mean, I think women also firstly think about lots of other things other than thinking about women, which we do. Yeah. But we also care about the world. We also care about what's happening in violence. We care about good writers. We see a writer as a writer. And Manta was a feminist writer in any case. So I don't think that just having a woman protagonist, for instance, in India, there have been films, you know, which has women as protagonists, but they are extremely sexist films. They are not really feminist films. Just having a woman at the center doesn't make... You can have few women characters or whatever women characters. Are they layered? Are they interesting? Do they have a voice? You know, all of those are more important. So sometimes we make these things very simplistic, and I think they're far more complex, and that's where the intent comes in. If you truly have that intent, you'll find a way to do it.
Well, you know, when you look at the action movies as an example, and they were all, you know, male stories and male directors, and then now slowly you can see action movies coming into, you know, those big budget films that the studios do with a woman lead, and they've seen the results, you know, that it actually worked, and because women make the decisions of which movies couples go to see. So, you know, it's...
That's debatable, but...
there is one thing that I wanted to mention.
Please.
Well, like with Free the Bid, it's helping women become commercial directors so they can be have a sustainable life so they can make films. And I think that that's like a big part of the reason why I started making commercials. And because being an independent filmmaker is not easy. It's not really sustainable. And this is a way for women to actually like create that type of life where they're not struggling at all times. So I think I just wanted to mention that as well. Yeah.
Great. So this is a conversation that needs to happen more often. This is a conversation that perhaps we need to bring more people in the senior levels of the producing studios. I think as a marketer that the voice of the customer, the people that go to the movies, have not been felt as strongly in the film industry as they are being felt in the consumer goods business, and that's something that we're going to need to get significantly better at. So I want to thank you all for participating with us today. I want to thank you all for the last 2 days and your attention. We've been blessed, and the word is blessed, by the relationship that we've had with the film industry. From our founders, whose first commercially viable product was the audio oscillator for the movie Fantasia, to all the work that you've seen over the last 2 days. We've helped make films better, but this industry and its connection with people and storytelling has also made us a much better company in terms of the innovation and our ability to connect. 2 years ago, we made a decision to split, and we had an opportunity to renew our vows with the film industry, and we did. And we will continue to be behind this industry, whether it is in technology, whether it is supporting female directors, or whether it is supporting commercial directors, not because it's a values issue, but also because it's a business imperative. So thank you very much for your attendance, and hope you continue to enjoy Cannes. Thank you.
Thank you.